It's mostly park and very good runnability. A couple of years ago, we had here at the Finnish Championships for the older runners, for 35 years old forward for the sprint races, and the map is very good, and also terrain very good and fast runnability. So I believe we are going to see very, very tough and fast race today. Estimated winning time for each leg is quite close to 14 minutes. So that means that a little bit under 1 hour or 1 hour it will take. Then we know which country will take the first gold medal of these championships. We have now, as I said, 25 minutes to the start, and you have already checked out all the best places to follow the competition. You have seen the public control and the passage through the competition center, and then, of course, the last control. Then, I'm not saying from which direction they are coming to the last control. Maybe you have some questions for that, but you will see that later this afternoon, when the competitors will then enter the stadium area first time. Totally 23 teams will run today in this mixed relay. And we go later through those teams and the runners for each team. I hope you enjoy your time, and I hope we are going to see very tight and fair fight for the gold, silver and bronze medals during this evening here at Tyrnävä. And as we know, tomorrow we will continue the races with the middle distance competition at Lapua. And from there we continue. We come back to Seinäjoki. In the center of town, we have then the sprint competition on Thursday. And then continuing on Friday with long distance and Saturday's relays at Kuortane. And of course, audience has maybe seen here on the screen that using the hashtag VOK2018 on your Twitter and Instagram feeds, you can put feelings from Finland, from warm, warm Finland. It's been over 30 degrees during these last days, and when we have checked out prognosis for the next days, it's going to be the same or even warmer in the next days. So now we just wait for a small while before we go through the competitions a little bit closer and see the teams and the runners in each team, and then we wait for the first leg runners to arrive to the stadium area, to the competition center for the start, which will happen at 4 o'clock, so in 23 minutes. I hope you enjoy your time here in Finland, and of course enjoy the competition, which will start very soon. time is now so much that the first leg runners has left the quarantine area and are on the way to the competition center. So soon we have 23 first leg runners and 23 women here at the competition center. And here they are, as I said, arriving
to the warm-up area.
So they were faster than I thought.
Arriving here.
Taking some refreshments.
We have very, very warm weather. Now we have Finland. Today is a thermometer, so it's at plus 32 degrees. So very, very warm.
But sprint.
For these women and also for the men, today 14 minutes approximately is the estimated winning time for each leg. Women's leg is 3.6 kilometers and total climb will be approximately 30 meters. And for men, 4.3 kilometers and the climb a little bit over 30 meters.
3 minutes
before the start, I give permission for the runners to arrive to the start area.
So you will have now
plenty of time to warm up here at the competition center.
Or cool down,
maybe be the better word for that.
We have there.
Anita Steer for Austria. Anja Arpter for Australia, of course, and is there. Anja Arpter for Austria. Emma Wedding from Team Canada. Czech Republic's first runner will be Karolina.
And for China, Ming Chong. Finland's first leg runner, Janina Gustafsson. For France, Delphine Poirot. Germany, Susan Lösch. Hungary, Virak Wieler. And for Ireland, Niamh Corbet. Italy's first leg runner is Irene Bozzebon, and for Japan, Zuzu Manuzawa. Lithuania's first leg runner is Milda Ratjevaitner,
and for New Zealand, Hayley Stuhlberger, Norway's Aiden Svanøe Haustad, and for Slovakia, Lucia Kovalančíková, Spain, Marina Garcia Castro, Finland, Switzerland, Pamba Gross, Great Britain, Cecil Anderson, and for USA, Evelyn Boysam are the 23 first leg runners. And we'll be seeing them when I give permission 3 minutes before the start, take the places at the start area.
And soon exactly 15 minutes
have we time for to start here before
these 21st University World Championships will begin, the first competition of these championships and the mixed sprint relay.
3 minutes before the start, I give the order to all the athletes to arrive to the starting area. They will be in the three lines. And then maps are handed out 1 minute before the starting time. And when everybody has got their map, you are allowed to take the rubber band off the map, but not allowed to watch the map, of course. That will be allowed after my command, which will be the word go at 16 o'clock, which will be in 13 minutes. First leg runners are taking their position there in the shadow, of course, very warm, so you don't need to warm up, so maybe a little bit more than cool down before you enter to the first leg, which is, as I've been saying, 3.6 kilometers with 17 front rows on this Jussi Pasasen course. Map is 1 to 4,000 with the contour interval 2 meters. So very good readability on a map, as I told here earlier. And when I follow here all the runners warming, it looks very, very good. Taking some fast running here before start. But of course, we all have our favorites. Maybe if I ask from the Austrian team who is their favorite, it's of course the Austrian team. But if I ask from Australians, the Australian says that it's Australia which is our favorite for today's race. But I have checked out a little bit on my list, and maybe, of course, I wait quite a lot from our own team, Team Finland. Daniela Gustafsson, Jonas Ahola, Aleksi Anttila, and Alexandra Englund.
The other 22 teams. Czech Republic has also very tough team. Sikova, Sikora, Minar, Horičíková. Horičíková. Who is world junior champion in relay from a couple of years ago and running very well the last years. French, Germany, also good teams on my papers. Florence Hanner running for the last leg for the French. She was fastest on junior world championships relays first leg and also fourth in a sprint, so very good last break runner we have for the French team. Norway is always a tough one. Svanø Haustad, Moen Persli,
Banchen and Aiden.
Akiamovic, Volovic and Hornik, Russia.
David partner Volov and Hornik, Russia. And maybe, of course,
Marina Garcia Castro for Lorenz,
Spain. Marina Garcia Castro for Lorenz, seventh. Eduardo Gilmar for Maria Pires del Campo. Del Campo was seventh in the Junior World Championship sprint. Air Cablo, so close.
Which land always been on the top? Are they also today? That will be seen later.
Or are they?
When we have now 10 minutes to the start. And then we have the Swedish first leg runner warming up, Linnea Gulsater, 21 years old runner. She had a birthday here on Saturday, so grattis, grattis Linnea. Födelsedag på lördag.
Mä
So now we have this big question in the air. Who will win these championships first gold medal? We have 23 teams and only one of them can take it. And of course, silver and bronze is there up for grabs. So everything is open now when we have 8 minutes to go. Now, for a small while, you have to be there, the first leg runners, and wait until I give the permission to come to the start area. And of course, the coaches and teammates which are not running, you can come closer and closer to the start area to cheer up for your landmates at the start moment. There we have now Janina Gustafsson having some last advices from the coach Tero Föhr. What should she do
what
today?
Should she do today?
After. Result is the
result
best
is possible. The best possible.
Australia, Austria,
Canada, Czech Republic, China, Finland, France, Germany, Hungary, Ireland, Italy, Japan, Lithuania, New Zealand, Norway, Poland, Russia, Slovakia, Spain, Sweden, Switzerland,
and USA are the nations fighting for the first medals in these World University Orienteering Championships here at Finland. Now we are at the Seinäjoki. Later during this week we'll be running at Lapua and also at Kuortane. So enjoying these Austropotamian terrains during this week. And this music means that it's runners runs there, and soon it's time for enter the area for the start. It's getting closer and closer to the moment that these championships really begin here in Finland. These are the 21st World University Orienteering Championships. And it's wonderful that this university running family is here at Finland. And now we have 3 minutes to the start, so now it's time to take your place at the start area. 3 minutes to the start. And here they come, the first leg runners for these 23 teams. There are for Australia, Lanita Steyr, Austria, Anja Arpter, Canada, Emma Waddington, Czech Republic, Karolina Sikova, China, Ming Chong, Finland, Janina Gustafsson, France, Delphine Poirot, Germany, Susan Lösch, Hungary, Virag Wieler, Ireland, Niamh Corbett, Italy, Irene Botsevon, Japan, Zuzu Mazuvazava, Lithuania, Milda Ratsiovaite, New Zealand, Heidi Stolberger. Norway, Eirin Svanö Halstad. Poland, Agata Stankiewicz. Russia, Anastasia Boronkova. Slovakia, Lucia Kovalinčiková. Spain, Marina Garcia Castro. Sweden, Linnea Gåsater. Switzerland, Paula Gross. Great Britain, Cecily Anderson. And USA, Evelyn Brochikam. This beautiful group, 23 runners. Ready for the fight, for the medals here.
Ready for the fight.
We have now 2 minutes to the start. So soon the maps are handed out when we have 1 minute to start.
So soon the maps are handed out when we have 1 minute to start. So
one minute to the start. The maps
are handed out.
You are not allowed to watch the maps. 1 minute to start. The maps are handed out. You are not allowed to watch the maps. All teams has now the maps. You are allowed to take the rubber band off.
All teams has now the maps. You are
30 seconds to the start.
30 seconds to the start.
It's now close. These championships will begin in 15 seconds. Go! And there they go, these 23 teams to the first 3.36 kilometers long leg. Who will be first out? Men are already here, the second leg runners. They saw the women starting, and now they waiting for maybe 10 minutes before the women arrive here to the competition center for the Pashas throughout arena. And here we can see from the bird overview when women are heading towards the first controls. Here, there we have a number 9 leading. It's France and Delphine Poirot, followed by Hungary and Virag Viler. They're on the second base. Then there is Finland, Czech Republic. Norway's there. So very fast they are heading towards the first controls. Number 5, there is Czech Republic, Karolina Sikova, now leading this group of 23 teams. There is also now coming Switzerland. If I saw right, Paula Gross there. Yes, passing there. And here you can see the women heading towards the first controls. France in the lead there. And there they are punching at the first control very fast, heading forward. Czech Republic, Karolina Sikova in the lead. Followed there by Norwegian Eirin Svanö Halvstad. They are there firing very fast when women there heading for the next controls. Small caps there. Here we have Switzerland, Paula Gross, followed by their Czech Republic, Norway in the lead. And they are running very, very fast at the moment, heading for the next control. So this means that we are going to, as I assume, we are going to have a fast sprint relay today here at Seinäjoki and Tärnava, Finland. We have also Hungary there behind. Switzerland, France, they're a little bit ahead. And for Hungary, the first leg runner is Virag Viler. In a 1-1 long line, they are now handling there. And here you can see a little bit from the screen and on all scores, you who are at the home so far following this competition, how the women are heading for towards the next controls. Hungary and Virag Viler in the lead, 24 years old Hungarian runner. They're leading this group, followed there by France and the same Delphine Poirot. Delphine was running already this spring in the Switzerland in the European Championships, representing Lillemark also here in Nordic countries. And it looks to be so that France is in the lead. Hungary right behind, then Russia there, and for the Russian, Anastasia Borovgova running for Russia, Switzerland, Paula Gross, Czech Republic, Karolina Sikova are the top five currently when they are heading maybe one third of the course. They have been running for 5 minutes and we are waiting them here at the competition center for after 10 minutes running. And here they come to our next TV control. We have there our man running with the camera, and there are France in the lead, followed by Hungary. And it looks very good for these two teams. They are now a couple of meters ahead of other teams. France, Hungary, Delphine Poirot and Virag Viler. Side by side, they are heading towards the next controls. And there you can see the difference, which is maybe 5, 6, 7 seconds before we have their Switzerland and the other teams heading here towards the arena. It takes maybe 2 minutes and then they are here at the arena, 2-3 minutes. And now Virag Viler from Hungary taking the lead. Delphine Poirot on the second place, just following a couple of seconds behind. And here you can see Great Britain, Sweden, Finland, maybe 30 seconds behind the leading team, Hungary and France, currently on the first leg. And the second leg runners, men, they are ready here at the competition area, waiting for the women to arrive. France, Hungary, Switzerland, Russia. And you can see a little bit different route choices made here for the ninth control by Switzerland, Hungary, France. And now it looks that they are quite equal here at ninth control. Interesting to see how big group we have here when they enter the arena. And very soon, maybe 1 minute, and then they are here at the corner of the arena. Soon. And at the currently, when we look the GPS, it looks to be Hungary and Virag Viler leading this group of 23 women. France, Russia, Czech Republic, Switzerland there. And Paula Gross now in the same group with Hungarian and French runner. Is it Switzerland and Paula Gross who is coming there first in a corner of this arena and then passing here behind the audience? And I'm looking now there in the corner, and there they come, the three teams. It's Hungary in the lead, Switzerland, France. In this order they come to this intermediate control, punching there. Hungary, Switzerland, France. And what a pace they have now been running for 8.5 minutes. And passing Russia, Anastasia Borogova on the fourth pace. Czech Republic, Karolina Sikova. Then comes Norway. And Hungary, Virag Wieler passing to arena first. A couple of meters behind her comes Switzerland, Paula Gross, and France, Delphine Poirot, followed by the Russian Anastasia Borovkova. Difference from Hungary to Russia is 8 seconds. Then they are coming, Czech Republic, Karolina Sikova, Norway, Elin Svanø Halvstad. Sikova is 16 seconds behind, leading Hungary. Difference to Norway. Norway is 24, Spain, Marina Garcia Castro, 26 seconds behind. And then come Japan, Great Britain, Canada, Slovakia, Poland, Australia, Sweden, Finland, Lithuania, Austria, in that order. Japan and Canada, 37, 38 seconds. Also Great Britain, Slovakia there. After that, after Slovakia, Poland, 48 seconds behind. Sweden, Australia, 49. And then comes after Poland, Finland. Finland, Janina Gustafsson, 1 minute and 1 second behind leading Hungary at our intermediate control here at the stadium area. Austria, Anja Arpter, Lithuania, Midla Ratsivoidnaite there on the 16th and 17th place. Then we have Italy and Ireland, next one to come here. And this means that when women are passing to arena, the men are allowed to come to the changeover area. You can take your map, but of course you are not allowed to take the rubber band off. That's allowed right after the start has happened and changeover has happened. Women are now on the other side of this small river here, and it looks to be Sweden, Hungary, Russia, France in a group, and then Czech Republic, Norway. And we have here at the arena United States, Evelyn Brodikam, and China, Ming Chong, passing to arena. Still France, Switzerland, Hungary, Russia in the lead. And for France is Adrien Delaine here waiting at the start area for Delphine Poirot. For Hungary, Levent Tugui. For Russia, it's Sergei Popov. And for Switzerland is Jonas Egger. They are ready. They will be, I might say, the first one to get out to the second leg here. And it doesn't take maybe 1.5 minute, and they are here at the arena. And the first changeover will happen. Women has now used 12 minutes, and the estimated time was 13 minutes and 50 seconds. So interesting to see how close will be when they enter back to the arena. They have now used 12 minutes and 40 seconds. And they are, men are ready. And as I said in the first group, will be Wojciech for Hungary, Levent Tugui. For Russia, Sergei Popov. For Switzerland, Jonas Egger. And for France, Adrien Delaine. These four teams are maybe 25 seconds ahead of the other teams. There are Canada, Great Britain, Norway, Spain, Czech Republic, Sweden, and Finland behind these teams. And here they come. It's Hungary in the lead. And is it going to be Virag Viler who is going to take the first leg victory in these championships? It looks to be so. And there is Paula Gross just a couple of seconds behind her. Hungary, Switzerland, then France and Russia. The first one to lead, and it's Virag Viler from Hungary taking the first leg, and Levent Tugui going out there, then Switzerland, France, Russia. And then we wait for a small wind before we have the next group to arrive. There will be Canada, Slovakia, Great Britain, Spain, Germany, Norway, Poland. These teams are arriving. Here we have Canada, Emma Waddington, Adam Woods going out. Slovakia, Lucia Kovalanchkova, Tomas Musinski, Great Britain, Spain, Poland, Norway. And Norway on the 10th place, 49 seconds behind leading Hungary currently at the first changeover. Then we have their Czech Republic, Finland, Sweden. Finland and Sweden, 1 minute, 4 seconds, 1 minute, 7 seconds behind when they enter the stadium. And they have Jonas Ahola, the birthday man of this day, and Ville Johansson going out for Finland and Sweden, and just ahead of them, Czech Republic and Wojciech Sikora. And here now we are going to take the interview of the first leg fastest woman, Virag Viler from Hungary. We wait and see Virag to the interview first to check out all the punching ready there from all teams.
Mixing away.
There we have also Japan, Masu Masuzawa finishing, Masaya Taniguchi going out, Australia, Lanita Steer, Henry McNulty changing, then 1.5 minute behind leading Hungary, and Austria 1:40 behind Hungary, and there is Matthias Reiner now running the next leg. And now we are going to have Virag Viler here. First leg winner from Hungary here at the Finnish area. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
How was it? You were in the lead almost all the time. How was the first leg?
It was really fast and it was good for me. And I didn't see any other controls, so I don't know if there was any
forking.
Yeah. And yes, it was fast and not so difficult.
Okay, so it was just to run as very fast and hold focus, that you are concentrated all the time. You didn't have any problems. You saw all the time the others. How much did that affect on your running?
It was good to see the other girls, and I had some mistakes in the end of the course, but not so big, so it was quite good.
This was excellent start for Team Hungary. What was your main goal for today's race? Fighting for medals?
No, I don't know. We just want to have a good race and do our best. So.
And enjoy running and enjoy orienteering like it used to be. Congratulations to Virag Viler, the winner of the first leg. So now back to the race. Men are there on their first leg, so-called for men's first leg. Men's first leg, which is 4.3 kilometers, 21 controls. We have here New Zealand and Kieran Woods going out to this leg, and we have Hungary. They're still in the lead. We have here Russia running, and Russia's second leg runner is Sergei Popov, very tough runner. He has been running 3,000 meters for 9 minutes, so this man has strength to push up in this very fast terrain, as Virag Wieler told us. Here we see Hungary, France, Switzerland, Russia, and we see Hungary already maybe 25 seconds ahead of the all the other teams. So there we have Levente Tugui in the lead, pushing towards the sixth control, followed by the Frenchman Adrien Delaine, 22 years old, who had also birthday last Saturday. So the Frenchman has just has a party throughout the last weekend, first own birthday and then the French jubilee in World Championships in football. There we have the situation after first leg. Hungary in the lead. And as you see, top 10 in 50 seconds. And Australia 1.5 minutes behind on the 16th place. So quite tight still. Anything is possible when we go out on the second leg of this relay. And now it's of course interesting to see how this can happen, these changes throughout this race. Here we see now, wait, it's Russia here approaching. And there is now small gaps between these runners. After France, it was Norway, Trudena, Mue, Persley, Poland. And after Poland, there is Spain and Paul Lorenz Kaelas running for Poland. And here you can see, as Virag says, she didn't see any other controls, but as you can see, there is some forking, of course, when we have a relay here. Hungary still in the lead, followed by France, Switzerland, and now Russia, maybe 15 seconds behind Switzerland when they are heading towards the next controls, maybe more than 15. So we have three teams a little bit ahead of the others. Hungary, France, Switzerland, followed by Russia, and then again 15 seconds gap to Norway, Poland, and Spain, Great Britain. And here we have the leader of the competition, Hungary. And Levente Tugui, 25 years old runner, pushing as hard as he can and maybe knowing that he is in the lead. And men, they are of course approaching here to arena, and we have here the third leg runners, second leg for the men. Men are here and they know the situation. And also the last leg runners, women's last leg, they are arriving also to the arena just now. Here they go, Hungary and France now together. Switzerland, couple of meters behind. And here you see, maybe 10 seconds gap from France and Hungary to Switzerland. Then there is 20 seconds to Russia. And Norway and Poland are all the way getting closer and closer to Russia. And not too far away are Spain, Great Britain and Slovakia. Next there. And now it takes maybe 1 minute. And the top teams are here passing the arena second time in this relay. And there they are together. Dugui and Delen and Egger chasing this duo when they are heading to arena. And now we look our taking a side towards the public control in the end of arena. And there I see they are now entering. There they come. Hungary and France in the lead. Adrian Delen has taken the lead. Punching there right now. And the difference, as you see, it's only a couple of meters when Levent Dugui is on the second base, followed by Switzerland and Jonas Egger. And difference is 10 seconds from leading France to Switzerland. Delen just saying hello and giving thumbs up, everything going very well. Hungary on the second place. Excellent from Team Hungary, which came here for enjoy just. And Switzerland, Jonas Egger currently on the third place. Difference from France to Hungary, as we saw, it's not a lot. 3 seconds, Switzerland nine. And at the same time, we have the next teams approaching here and coming. There are Norway and Poland. And then first comes Russia, who has fallen down now on currently sixth place. For Norway, Trondheim and Moen Pedersen punching here. And the difference is 45 seconds. So they have to push up a little bit more. And Poland, Piotr Parfiamowicz there together with Moen Pedersen. Then comes Russia, 10 seconds later, and already Spain passing Russia here. Paul Lorenz Kaleas is 10 seconds behind Norway, Poland, and heading behind there, pushing as hard as he can. And also Great Britain, Jonathan Crickmore, as hard as he can, we know, pushing at everything. And Slovakian Tomas Mushinski checking out where the others are going, seeing that there we should go. And then comes the big group. Czech Republic first, followed by Finland, Germany, Australia, Sweden, Austria, and a couple of seconds behind this group comes Canada. And first here, Czech Republic, Wojciech Sikora, followed by the birthday man, Jonas Ahola. And then Australia, Henry McNulty, Germany, Moritz Delgast, Sweden, Ville Johansson, Austria, Matthias Reiner, there. Canada, Adam Woods. And it takes maybe 1.5 minutes, and then we have the next changeover. So we have here four friends, Arno Perrin, Daniele Farefari for Hungary, Joey Hodor for Switzerland. These top three teams, they will be the first one to go out. Chased by Norway, Poland, Spain, Russia, and so on. As you can see now, France in the lead, followed by Switzerland and Hungary. So France and Adrien Delen is pushing very, very hard there. So it's going to be, looks like that the France will be going out first if no miracles happens here in the last part of this second leg. Adrien Delen has been very, very good during this second leg, and Arno Perrin will go out first. Here he is getting ready. And together there with Joey Hadorn, they are ready for the fight, which will take approximately 14 minutes for these men. And here they come, and you see the gap isn't big. There they are, France, Hungary, and Switzerland. In this order, they are coming. Adrien Delaine, Levent Tugui, Jonas Egger, approaching here. And Arnaud Perrin will be going first out. Hungary, Levent Tugui, Daniel Farefari, Farefari going out, and Switzerland, Jonas Egger changing to Joey Harder, and there they go. And next, we wait to see what will be the difference for the changers. There are Poland and Norway. Piotr Parfiamovic and Rondeinar Muenpeders-Li. And the difference is 40 seconds. Christopher Volochik and Doug Blanchen are going out on the third leg. First Norway and then Poland straight after. And the difference is a little bit under 40 seconds. It's 38 seconds from the fifth and fourth and fifth place. And then Spain. Paul Lorenz Calleas changing for Eduardo Gil Marcos. And the cap is 1 minute, 12 seconds for the Spains to catch up to France. Great Britain, Jonathan Clickmore is then the next one. Clickmore coming, Alexander Chepelin going out. Clickmore pushing as hard as he can the last meters. And Chepelin goes out here. There. And after Great Britain, Slovakia, Russia, Finland, and Australia, Sweden. So here, many teams close to each other. For Slovakia, Martti Jonas goes out. For Russia, Kirill Komarov. For Finland, Aleksi Anttolainen. Australia, Aidan Dawson. Oskar Sandberg for Sweden, and for Czech Republic, Marek Midan, and Germany. Austria wants to be also a part of that group. There are Moritz Delgast and Matthias Reiner coming in, and Bojan Blumenstein and Matthias Gröll going out on the second leg. So France, Hungary, Switzerland, Poland, Norway, Spain, Great Britain is the order at the first, at the second changeover. And now we have Adrien Delaine in the interview here at the finish area. We take an interview here fast with Adrien. Adrien Delaine, very, very good race. First one come in here. I know there was some problems, but I believe it's just that controls are not waking up, but I believe everything is okay. How was the race?
Yeah, it was, for me, it was quite good. I mean, except at the beginning, I lost some seconds at the control where the emit were not beeping, but I was with Jonas, and we will speak about this later. But after, it was quite good, very high-speed race. You have to run quite fast, and in my opinion, the forest areas are not very easy to run, so you have to try to avoid it. But yeah, that was fun, and yeah, a good sprint really, and I hope the end will be as good as we are.
Yeah, we hope that it takes to. There are now three teams a little bit ahead, France, Hungary, and Switzerland. Also tough fight, and of course you hope every good for the team France. What are your expectations?
Yeah, we have a good team, quite young, and after finish with Arnaud and Florence, I know it will be a very good because they are in good shape, and I hope the end will be nice.
Thank you very much, and we hope all the best for the French team for the next two legs. Thanks.
Thank you.
Adrien Delaine, Frenchman, taking Frenchman to the lead after second leg. And now here we have teams heading Switzerland, France and Hungary in that order, heading towards the next one. And here we are running with the guys. André Perrin for France, Joey Hadorn for Switzerland, and Daniel Farefari for Hungary. Switzerland and France are a little bit ahead of maybe 20 seconds of the Hungary, and then comes Norway and Poland. Maybe 25 seconds from Hungary is the difference. So is it going to be these two teams fighting for gold medal? Difference from the first team to the 10th team, which was Finland here at the second changeover, was 1 minute 45 seconds. So quite it is. And then we saw France passing this control. And then we wait for the next teams. And then comes Hungary on a third place. And then there is this gap of 20 seconds before Norway and Poland are, and now Switzerland and Joey Hadorn is currently in the lead when we look at the GPS and the difference to France and Arnaud Perrin is maybe 10 seconds. And for the last leg, we have Martin Arush for Switzerland and from France, Florence Hanneur, who was fourth in the Junior World Championships this year. And we all know also Martina as a tough runner, although she had injuries during this spring, but now she is in excellent shape. Last week she has shown us that the injuries are behind and now she is in excellent shape. Here they are now heading towards next controls, Switzerland, France. And of course, when we are here at the town area where the buildings are a little bit giving a shadow to the GPS, it looks that they are making some mistakes, but no, here is Joey Hadorn in the lead for Switzerland for this third leg. What a fight we have had now and still continuing. Difference now is between these two top teams, Switzerland and France, maybe 15 seconds. It looks very good for Joey Hadorn, who sprung run very well for the qualification races at Latvia. Here a couple of weeks away for the World Championships. And there goes Hadorn and France. As you can see from the tail of the GPS, it's almost 15 seconds. And here is France and Arnaud Perrin fighting as hard as he can and try to catch up Joey Hadorn. And then we wait to see how close or how far away is Hungary and Daniel Fehervari. And the difference is getting bigger. And as you can see, Norway and Dag Blanchen is getting closer and closer to Hungary. And Poland is not so far away either. Here you can see the difference in a real life, in real picture, no GPS. It's only 5-6 seconds from Hungary to Norway. And Poland maybe as much behind, they're behind Norway as they were from Hungary. So there is a very good fight for the third place also. And now we look towards the public control. heading towards here. How big is the gap when we wait? Joey Haddon, there he is, Swedish runner. Joey Haddon going over the ditch and bunching there at the control. Right now, flying towards the next one, and then we can see with our own eyes here at the competition center how big is the gap from Switzerland to France. It's almost 15 seconds, it's maybe more, and now Haddon knows it, and also Perrin knows it. It's 18 seconds exactly when they are now passing here to Arena. Haddon pushing as hard as he can, so is also Perrin. And Martina Rusch and Florence Hanner are ready here for the fight on the last leg. Now men passing here the arena. First Switzerland, then France, and we are not yet seeing the third team there. And it's already Norway. Norway has climbed up. Dag Blaugen has taken and passing Hungary, and now Norway on the third place, 57 seconds behind the leading Switzerland. Hungary and Poland right behind there, only a couple of seconds behind, but now it looks also good for Norway. Ingeborg Eide is ready for the last leg. Here passing Tjarenan, Dag Blaugen from Norway. And it looks quite tough for Hungary and Daniel Fahervari, and Esther Manutuano is the last leg runner. Then Poland, next one to come here, Spain also. Eduardo Guirimarcos coming here, and Maria Diego del Campo is ready. They're giving the last strength to Guirimarcos, and followed by Great Britain, Alexander Chapelin and Mekka Carter-Davies. For Finns, Megan is quite known, running for Rajamäen Rykmentti. She's ready here for the last leg. And Great Britain, they are 1 minute and 1 minute and 56 seconds behind on the seventh place. Then following Finland, Aleksi Antolainen here passing to arena. And Finland is 2 minutes 19 seconds behind. Sweden, Oskar Sandberg, Czech Republic, Marek Minar, Russia, Kirill Komarov, Australia, Aidan Dawson, and Germany, Bojan Blumenstein. These are the teams passing here to arena. So now we have soon 13 teams passed here. The arena. And soon we are going to have the last changeover. Switzerland already on the second last control, soon heading here to arena, and the difference has grown. It was 19 seconds when they passed the arena, and now it is over half a minute maybe when Martina Rusch is getting out on the last leg. So very strong leg for Joey Haddon. And here he is coming now, soon heading towards the last control there, coming to the field and punching there right now at the last control. In the lead, Switzerland, Joey Haddon coming in, and last leg runner is Martina Rusch. Martina is ready here to go out for the women's 3.6 kilometer long course, and there is the changeover. And then we want to see what is the difference for the chasers France. Florence Honneur is ready here. Arnaud Perrin punching there on the last control. It's 30 seconds the difference. Half a minute. Time to chase for Florence. It means 10 seconds on red every kilometer. She has to catch up almost. And there goes Honneur out. She was, as I said, fourth in junior championship sprint, so very tough. Last leg runner for French man. Then we're waiting for Norway. The gap was almost 1 minute. That is going to take almost 1 minute. There comes Blanchen. Blanchen there punching Norway on the third place. 1 minute, 8 seconds behind. Ingemar Eide there going out. And Poland. Krzysztof Wolonczyk and Alexander Hornik goes out. Hornik, who is also known here in Finland, running for Paimion Rasti, goes out on the last leg. So now we have there Martina Rus, Florence Honneur fighting for the, might say, for the gold for Switzerland and France. And then Norway, Poland fighting for the bronze. Difference is over 1 minute. For Eide and Hornik, so we have two duos there right now. When we have then the next teams to arrive, there we have Hungary, Spain, Great Britain, Fahervari, Dil Marcos, Chepelin coming out, Mantuano, Del Campo and Carter Davies going out for the next leg. And We wait a small while, and then we have to interview of the first leg winner, Joey Haddon here. We have there Finland, Sweden, Austria, and Czech Republic next to come. We take this group to finish the changeover before the interview. And there they come, this group. First, Sweden. And Finland first. Aleksi Antolainen coming in. Alexandra Enlund goes out. Sweden, Oskar Sandberg, Emma Biesmo. And Austria, Matthias Gröll, Anna Nilsson Sinkovic. For Austria and Czech Republic, Marek Minar, Vendula Horičiková on 11th place. 2 minutes 51 seconds behind leading Switzerland, Joey Haddon. And now we have Haddon here ready for the interview. He had excellent race. Here is Joey ready. Congratulations, Joey. What a run.
Yeah, it was really nice, but quite fast, I think so. And we expected more, like fences or I don't know. But yeah, I can push it up to my limits, and then I saw the gap is get bigger and bigger behind me.
Yeah, you maybe waited more technical, but today it was just push up as hard as you can and still stay calm during this race. What do you say now? 30 seconds, is it enough?
Yeah, we will see. We have excellent runner on the fourth leg, but also the other countries have some strong runners on the last leg, and it's sprint relay, so it's his own rules, but we will see. I hope really.
We hope so. Thank you, and now it's time for the last leg, and we enjoy it, and then we see who will take the first goal.
Thanks.
Joey Haddon, winner of the third leg, and I'm in the lead here, and Switzerland in the lead by half a minute before the French men. And so we have now Rusch and Hanauer there fighting in the lead. For women, and the difference is quite shame. Here we have still the situation at and standings at changeover. 12 teams among 3 minutes. So Russia on 12th place. Then Germany, Austria, and Slovakia on 15th place. And here we see GPS, Switzerland in the lead, and the gap is 20 seconds. They have there the same forkings at that place. Poland and Norway And now it's interesting to see what happens. There is Hornik and Eide fighting for the bronze medal. And heading towards the second next control. Here we are with Great Britain and Megan Carter-Davies heading towards the next controls. And what a pace has she also. And when at the same time, Japan and Canada changing here. Yoshie Katsuyama going out and Pia Blake for the last leg for Japan and Canada. And here we have Switzerland in a lead. Martina Rusch leading the group at the moment. And what is the difference for the chaser and Florence Hanner from France? And from GPS you can check out at that is a little bit over 25 seconds. Rush in the lead, and soon here at the stadium area at the competition center, it takes maybe 1.5 minutes before she is entering the arena. Here she goes, Martina Rusch, alone in the lead. She knows that the difference was almost a half a minute when she went out, punching here on eighth control. And this arena, it's the tenth one, so soon she is here. And the difference, is it approximately 20 seconds? So she is so much ahead of Andrian. Florence Hanner, that Hanner doesn't see her when they are now there under this bridge, entering towards the competition center. We are following here Martina Rusch, and soon she is here. I'm already looking towards the public control in the end of the arena. And now, maybe here we see the gap. There we see Martina Rusch heading away from this control, but where he is Florence Hanner. There she is coming to this ninth control, and it is 25, maybe this 30 seconds the difference between these two women. And they're on the public control soon. We have the leader of this competition, Switzerland, and Martina Rusch. I try to see there throughout the trees. There she is coming now, punching soon. 30 meters to go. Flying over the ditch, coming to the field here, and now punching there. At the public control, then running throughout this through the competition center. Martina Rusch and Switzerland in the lead. And then we wait for the France. And then we already see her, but what is the difference? It's now clock is ticking, 15 seconds. It's 20-25 seconds the difference when women have the last kilometer to run. Switzerland in the lead. And there is France coming, 28 seconds. So it's been quite chained throughout the leg. 13 already, and Poland. Alexander Hornik, and she is only 13 seconds behind France and Florence Hanner. So Hornik is flying today, and now pushing very hard. The difference between France and Poland, I can see already, it's getting smaller and smaller. Here it was 13 seconds at that control, and then when they have passed the arena, now it's interesting to see. France at 32 seconds, and Then Poland, 40 seconds, so cap is only 8 seconds. 4 seconds faster was Hornick throughout the competition center. And then comes Great Britain, Megan Carter-Davies. And Carter-Davies, maybe she knows already that the Frenchman Florence Honneur is tired. So it's still possible to climb up to the medals, of course. Just pushing and pushing, Megan. Difference is 40 seconds to the medal, so everything is possible on these last kilometers. Norway, Ingvar Eide, there on the fifth place, followed by Finland, Alexandra Edlund. Then Spain, Maria Pietro del Campo, and Sweden, Emma Piesmo. When the USA team chasing here. And the difference from Norway to Great Britain was 19 seconds. Then Finland from Norway. And the cap there is when Alexander Enlund passing this control is 20 seconds to Norway from Finland. And Sweden only 7 seconds from Finland and then Spain together. So we have tough fight for top 8 places. And they are now there on these last controls of this competition. Switzerland in the lead. And here at the competition center, Austria, Anna Nilsson-Simkovic passing to arena the next one. Before her there was Hungary, Ester Matmuano, and also Russia and Germany has punched there at the public control. When we have already Switzerland heading towards the second last control. And it looks to be so that Switzerland will be the winner of first gold in these World University Orienteering Champions. Paula Gross, Jonas Ecker, Joey Hudder, and now Martina Rusch on the last leg, pushing as hard as they can, as she can towards the competition center and maybe already hearing us here. Then there are Poland and France, they are together. Poland, couple of meters ahead. When I look the GPS. So Poland now currently on the second place, followed by France, Great Britain. Then next. And soon we have here the winner of this race, Switzerland, heading here. A very tough fight. There is Hornick making a mistake there on the second last control, but also a small mistake for Hanner, though they are very close. But here is coming Martina Rusch for Switzerland. And punching on the last team control, and there they are, the whole team. And they are the winners of these World University Orienteering Championships, Switzerland, with the team Paula Gross, Jonas Ecker, Joey Hadorn, Martina Rusch. What a race! And the winning time today, 56 minutes and 55 seconds. And then we are waiting for the fight for the second place and silver medal. Poland and France, they are taking the different route choice to the last control. And then now there is Poland now coming for the second place. Excellent run. Agata Stankiewicz, Piotr Parfimovic, Krzysztof Wolowczyk, and now Aleksandra Hornik bringing Poland four silver medals. And then we have France. Delphine Poirot, Adrien Delaine, Arnaud Perrin, and Florence Honneur. Congratulations for the bronze medals. So what a fight, what a fight have we seen throughout the day. Switzerland, Poland, and France are the medalists. First medalist of these championships. And here comes Great Britain and Mecca Carter Davies on fourth place. Cecil Andersen, Jonathan Clickmore, Alexander Chaplin, and Megan Carter Davies on the last leg runner. And they were fourth. And then Norway. Ingeborg Eide, and after Norway, Finland. Alexander Enlund bringing Finland on the sixth place, just ahead of Spain. Spain, Maria Brieta del Campo bringing Spain on the seventh place, followed by Hungary. And Sweden first, Emma Biesmo. Emma Biesmo bringing Sweden on the eighth place. So we have eight teams at the finish, and the difference is 2 minutes and 5 seconds from the first to the eighth. And then there is a small gap to Hungary, Austria, Russia, Germany before they are entering the arena and fighting for top 10 places in this relay. And now, after top eight, there is a gap. Quite a big gap, all over a minute before we are now getting the next teams here. Hungary and Russia. There are now Russia, Anna Grovianskaya coming as the next team, and then Hungary, Esther Mantuano bringing Hungary. They started very well and finishing very well on the 10th place. Now Austria straight after there. So Russia here, Grovianskaya ninth, Hungary, Austria, and then Czech Republic, Vendula Horičiková running for Czech Republic and bringing Czechs on 12th place. And now it's already 5 minutes when we have here. And now we have Germany, Leonor Winkler bringing Germany on the 13th place. And then we are waiting for Slovakia, Australia, Japan, Canada, and Italy next here to finish. Italy has just passed the arena and they are on this last kilometer, so there is Australia and Slovakia next here to come. So what a race we saw. Very fast competition. When approximately estimated time for each leg was 14 minutes, so quite that it took, because the winning time was 56:55. Difference to Poland was 46 seconds, then France 57 seconds behind the winning Switzerland, Great Britain, Norway, Finland, Spain, Sweden, Russia, and Hungary is the top 10, followed by Austria, Czech Republic, and Germany. And now we wait for the next team, which is Australia. And for Australia, Anna Nilsson Sinkovic, sorry, Michelle Dawson, of course. And I look for Australia, not Austrian teams, running order here. So I'm waiting for Michel Dawson to the last control very soon. And now information for you who haven't running today, so you have possibility to run today these spring courses after we have all teams finished here this relay. We have now Ireland here passing to arena. And Rising Long, come on Rising, chill. And she gets some extra energy when we mark and give uploads to her. Heading towards the last kilometer, just behind Lithuania. And Vesta Ambrachaite. And then we have Australia, Michel Dawson heading here to finish, bringing Australia on a 14th place. And soon also New Zealand, China and USA are coming to the arena and to the public control. When we have now Slovakia and Ela Sedilekova heading here to finish and bringing Slovakia on a 15th place. And now we have there at the public control New Zealand heading here to the last loop, and then we have China and USA soon here. So Switzerland, Poland, France, Great Britain, Norway, Finland, Spain, Sweden were the top eight today in this tight race, followed by Russia, Hungary, Austria, Czech Republic, Germany, and Australia. And now also Slovakia at the finish as a 15th team. And New Zealand and Marina Komeski going there out on the last kilometer. And next, I'm waiting here for Japan, Team Japan to the finish, followed by Italy and Canada. They are very tight here, Italy, Martina Palumbo, and for Canada, Pia Blake together. And first there is Japan heading towards the finish, and Yoshie Katsuyama giving her best here. What a pace she has, bringing Japan on a 16th place. Here Japan at the finish, 16th, and then Italy and Canada fighting for the 17th place. And then we have here Italy, followed by Canada. First Italy, Martina Palumbo, and then Canada, Pia Blake, 17th and 18th place. And we have at the same time China, Chua Long, and Brigitte Bourdon for United States passing to arena. So next there is Lithuania and Ireland heading towards finish, and there is first coming Lithuania, and for Lithuania Vesta Ambrachaitė at last control. And here on the 19th place, Lithuania Vestambrachaita Premium Inter team at the finish here. And then we're waiting next Ireland, New Zealand, China and USA. And we are going to have the flower ceremony when we have all teams at the finish here at the podium area. And today, team leaders who are going to the St. Aoki Town evenings, your should be at 17:30 at information telt. So 17:30, team leaders who are going for St. Aoki Town's program. There, your should be at 17:30 at the information. And here we have now Ireland, Rosing Long, bringing Ireland on the 20th place. Giving everything, of course, to the course. Here at the finish today, her time was 17:19. Fastest last leg runner was Alexandra Enlund from Finland, 13:38. And second fastest was Emma Biesmo from Sweden, 13:41. And then Megan Carter-Davies ahead of Alexandra Hornik. And then we have three teams, New Zealand, Marina Komeski, China, Chuang Long, and United States. Brigitte Bordeaux still coming there. And next one is New Zealand, and Marina Komeski punching there on second last control, and soon heading here towards the competition center. And information for you who wants to run here in this beautiful warm weather. Is it possible right after all teams has finished this sprint relay in these World University Orienteering Championships? You can buy the map from the information here at the competition center. Tomorrow the competition will continue with the middle distance competition starting at 10 o'clock finish time in the morning at Lapua. And then the first individual medals are up to grabs there. And here we have now New Zealand and Maria Komeski coming towards last kilometer, last control. And for New Zealand, Heidi Stolberger, Kieran Woods, Oram Jonti, and now Marina Komeski on the last leg. Excellent to see these young runners come quite a long way to run these university championships. And here New Zealand on the 24th place. And at the same time, we have already China there on the last control. And for China is Xuan Long on the last leg. And for China, Ming Chong, Qing Hao Chong, Yuan Ling, and Xuan Long were the runners. And now when we are waiting for Team USA to finish, we are waiting and want to see the top three teams, Switzerland, Poland and France, please arrive to the podium area for the flowering ceremony. So Team Switzerland, Poland and France, please arrive to the flowering ceremony. And here we have now Team USA heading towards finish. Brigitte Bardon bringing the team with the good cheering. All teams have now finished with this wonderful atmosphere here at the Seinäjoki, Finland. In these university orienteering championships, 21st times these competitions are held, and now it's time for soon, very soon, for flower ceremony of these today's race. So I now ask top teams, Switzerland, Poland, and France, please arrive at the podium area. And as soon we have top teams there, we will start the flower ceremony of this mixed relay. I see there Switzerland, Poland I see already, and hopefully also French team. So Delphine Poirot, Adrien Delaine, Arnaud Perrin and Florence Honneur, please arrive beside the screen for the flower ceremony of this mixed relay. And now I'm also seeing French team arriving to the podium area, so we are getting ready for the flowering ceremony of these World University Orienteering Championships and first discipline mixed relay. All teams are now ready for flowering ceremony of the 21st World University Orienteering Championships here at Finland. So the flower ceremony of the sprint relay can begin. Teams now are allowed to take the places behind the podium. Here they are, coming the three best teams of World University Orienteering Championship 2018 and Mixed Sprint Relay. Flowers will be presented by Mr. Timo Ritakallio, President of the Finnish Olympic Committee, and Mr. Jorma Rasimäki, the Chairman of Seinäjoki City. Third, France, Delphine Poirot, Adrien Delaine, Arnaud Perrin, Florence Honneur. Thank you. second, Poland, Akantastankiewicz, Piotr Parfiamowicz, Krzysztof Wolowczyk, Aleksandra Hornik. Winners of the sprint mixed sprint relay, Switzerland, Paula Gross, Jonas Ecker, Joey Hadorn, Martina Rusch. We will hear the national, the anthem of FISU. So, congratulations to the top three teams of the sprint relay, Switzerland, Poland, and France. Tomorrow we will continue with the competitions, with the middle distance competitions, so then we have the new medals up for grabs. And now, we congratulate Switzerland, Poland, and France, first medals of these university orienteering championships here at Finland and Seinäjoki Kuortane, Lapua area. And now information for the all runners. Now it's possible to buy maps here from the event office if you want to run courses here. And remember all also the transportation back to the Kuortane, leaving here competition center with scheduled. Ja myös hetken kuluttua alkaa aivan tavalliset iltarastit, eli Finviis väki, tervetuloa suunnistamaan, kuten varmasti huomasitte. Maailmanmestaruuskilpailussa käytiin Emi Touchfree-järjestelmällä tätä, niin nyt käyvät järjestäjät vaihtamassa tuonne perinteiset Emitit rasteille, ja sen jälkeen pääsette kirmaamaan myös te tähän tällaiselle välipäivän sprintille. Minun puolestani on aika kiittää ja kumartaa. Tältä päivältä huomenna jatkamme aamulla sitten keskimatkan taistolla Lapualla Finviis-kisakeskuksessa mitalien jakoja. Kuette silloin ovat mitaleilla tuolloin luvassa ensimmäinen henkilökohtainen matka näissä opiskelijoiden maailmanmestaruuskilpailussa. Mestarit tänään olivat sveitsiläiset, hopea Puolaan ja pronssi Ranskaa. Thank you for my behalf and congratulations for the medalist. Remember now it's possible for a free orienteering. You can buy maps from...